All right, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, we want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushua, Bahashem, Makar Kadash, and that's the true Hebrew names of the Heavenly Father, in the name of His only begotten Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, and the Lashwan Kadash, the Holy Tongue, the Paleo Hebrew. We want to give a double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone who rule well and taught us this truth, and peace and salutations to you, Akim, that's pushing this word throughout the four corners abroad with truth and sincerity, and shalom to the Akim Wa'ath Watts. Peace and blessings to the brothers and sisters that may be listening, tuning in, and studying under the vibration of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Yahweh is who the world ignorantly calls the Most High God, Heavenly Father, and Yahweh means he is, he is to be, he exists. Bahashem means in the name. Yahweh Shai means is who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And Yahweh Shai means he's the Savior. He's the Deliverer. Bahashem in the name. Rakah Kadosh, the Holy Spirit. And we just two brothers out of the GMS Boston camp back here with a quick lesson. I'm the brother Taz Awar.
Bon Awar.
And we're just going to go flow through the spirit, man. We have an image of the Statue of Liberty and a huge fire coming from behind it, symbolizing the downfall and the lake of fire that John the Revelator seen to coming to Babylon the Great, a.k.a. America. This place is going to be utterly destroyed by that fire and brimstone, by them thermonuclear missiles. And we know that because it's through prophecy. Prophecy, and the Lord did nothing but reveal his secrets amongst his servants, the prophets. So when we see, you know, the lake of fire, when we see scriptures like arrows and, you know, this place is going to be made a wilderness in Babylon, these is all dark sayings and proverbs and parables to pretty much for the elect to decipher the clues of what's going to happen. And in these latter days, again, it doesn't say America, but you know, the in the scriptures they give clues of this place, say Babylon, you know, this is spiritually Egypt and spiritually Sodom. You know, the Lord left clues for us to identify what is this great kingdom and great nation that's going to be destroyed, and it's America. So, and we're just going to hear the move through the spirit. We ain't got nothing jotting down, so we just pray everything was edifying. I don't know if we want to start with Revelation, the 18th chapter, and we could read on down. Baba Kasha.
Revelation 18, verse 1. And after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having good power, and the earth was lightened with glory. Mm-hmm. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is fallen, and is become the habitation of devils, and the whole of every foul spirit, and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
Yeah, Khan, so this is the clues. Babylon the Great is fallen. These are the clues to identify what's going to happen to America. You know, and this place has became the habitation of devils and every foul spirit. And this place is going to be utterly destroyed again by them thermonuclear missiles. And it's the reason why it's going to go into it, why this place has to be destroyed, is because the philosophies, the wickedness have been pushed forth, you know, throughout the whole earth. And it started here mainly in America, man. Yeah. You know, you want to add something?
Yeah, America is the epicenter of wickedness. So that's exactly where Esau said, pretty much, and spew out his wickedness all over the earth, and that's the nation have adopted the ways, the philosophy, the custom of America, and that's how they committed fornication with her.
That's right. It goes into that the next verse.
Come on. It says, for all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication.
That's right.
And the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her.
That's right.
And the merchant of the earth or walks rates through the borders of a delicacy.
Yeah, and that goes back to what we were saying, that wine is representing their philosophies, their way of life. You know, the America has been the big influencer throughout the four corners of the earth, and you have to accept their democracy. If not, then they actually can put sanctions on you, steal your resources, or actually bomb you. Mm-hmm. You know, and this is why there's wickedness pushed throughout the earth, man, whether it's homosexuality, lesbianism, transgenderism, women liberation, the pushing of making pork a delicacy, you know, just disobedient children, so on and so forth. Even the lies of so-called religion, you know, you can have your own power, your own God, and looks like a so-called white man, or looks like a your own nation, whether these other gods, whether Buddha or Krishna, or, you know, so on and so forth. This is part of that philosophy that has been pushed, that wine that all these other nations pretty much have, the kings have taken and committed fornication with Babylon,
yeah,
right?
Adopted the philosophy, you know?
That's right.
Verse four. For I heard, you know, the voice from heaven saying, "Come out of her, my people, that she be not partakers of her sins, and that she receive not of her plagues."
And that's the Lord, you know, and He's gonna be speaking to the elect in the Hebrew, saying to come out of her, when this is going to be actually a physical departure, you know, because while the destruction and the plagues come to America, the Lord is going to deliver the elect, you know. The elect are not going to be here on earth to receive those plagues, and we know as them thermonuclear missiles, man.
Yeah,
you know,
if I may add a record, right, the devastation gonna be so chaotic, so huge, right? The Lord has to forcefully remove the elect from of the planet.
That's right. And we're telling you, too, it's gonna be by the chariots of the Heavenly Father, you know, and those are other more dark sayings. And they're not actually horses in the skies that's gonna pick us up. It's gonna be chariots, which the world thinks it's a sci-fi or a fiction, a so-called UFO. Those are actually the vehicles of the Most High, and that's the deliverance. That's the way out for the elect, man.
That's right, the salvation of the elect of the nation Israel.
That's right.
Says, for her sins have reached to the heavens, and the Most High had remembered her iniquities.
That's right. See, so lock it, bro. It always referenced Babylon or as a woman. It says her sins have reached into the heavens. What is it? The mystery of iniquity, the whore, you know, the daughter of Babylon.
Yeah.
And this is why the Statue of Liberty is a huge statue that's known throughout the world that represents America.
Yes, sir.
You know, and see, it says her sins have reached into the heavens, and America has been push nothing but iniquity after iniquity, sin and wickedness, and the Lord hasn't executed judgment expediently yet, but he's letting Americans or Babylonians, these Edomites, pretty much build up a tab, and then that's why the plagues is going to be the ultimate judgment for all the iniquities that Esau has done as a nation, as a whole, man.
Zechariah 2 verse 7, deliver thyself, O Zion, that dwelleth with the daughter of Babylon. So pretty much the nation of Edom is comparing to a woman, just like the nation of Israel, you know what I'm saying?
That's
so
right.
The nation in the Bible, usually they comparing the Lord are pretty much themselves for women, you know
that's
what I'm saying?
Right.
That's exactly how it is, you know?
Yes, that's why I think it's the President Lee says, stand beside her and guide her.
Yeah.
So the Babylon, aka America, is oftenly compared to a woman.
Yeah,
you know?
The Statue of Liberty.
Yeah, that's what we have on the screen.
Yeah, come on.
That's right, bro.
Come on.
You want to continue?
Verse 7. How much she had glorified herself and lived deliciously.
No, read verse 6.
Bro. Verse 6. Reward her even as she would a Jew, and double unto her double, according to her works, in the cup which she had filled to her double.
Yeah, see, then America has to receive double of that cup, double of that judgment, you know, that double of that oppression, you know, reward her double, you know, America or Esau, because when we say the downfall of Esau, it's synonymous with Babylon the Great, aka America, being destroyed, you know, they have to reap what they sow, and they're going to be rewarded double from the Lord, man. This is the will of the Heavenly Father.
That's right. It says how much she had glorified herself and lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow gave her.
That's right.
For she said in her heart, I see the queen, I am no widow and shall see no sorrow.
That's right. Hey, so she lived deliciously. You know, she's been comfortable. You know, she's been the hammer of the old earth. You know, she haven't had any resistance to take her, again, Babylon, America, out of power. But ultimately, the Lord is going to take her out of her seat, man, and destroy her utterly, man.
Yeah, and if I may add, right, that's exactly why she's known as the virgin daughter of Babylon, because she hasn't been touched, man.
That's
the only war that's pretty much took place here in America is the Civil War.
That's
it's either Edomites were fighting among themselves. other than that, there hasn't been any major war within the soil of America.
That's right.
Verse 8, therefore shall her plagues come in one day, death and mourning and famine, and she shall be utterly burnt with fire, for strong is the Lord Yahweh by Shemeshiah power who judges her.
See, and that's ultimately the will of the Heavenly Father Yahweh. You know, it says, for strong is the Lord Yahweh who judges her, and he's going to bring her plagues, you know, in one day, you know, mourning, death, and destruction, and famine. You know, and she shall early be burnt with fire. And again, we're telling you how that fire is going to happen. It's going to be by them thermonuclear missiles, you know. And all these, the Lord is pretty much setting the stage up for all these other nations that's getting ready for war. They're getting prepared for war. They have the nuclear capabilities, and they're setting themselves array, putting them weapons in array, meaning they're aiming their missiles towards America. That's America, right. Is the target, man.
That's right.
You know? So, and this is prophecy is gonna be fulfilled, you know. Yeah. Thus says Yahweh.
America has a bullseye on her ass, man. You know what I'm saying? That's exactly what it is, man. The target, this nation's target are pretty much aiming to America. You know?
That's right.
Verse 9, it says
And the kings
of the earth who have committed fornication and live deliciously with her, mm-hmm, shall be watered and lament for her when they shall see the smoke of a burning, standing afar off for the feet of a torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city Babylon, that mighty city, for in 1 hour is that judgment come.
And that's right. And only 1 hour is going to take for that mighty judgment of the Heavenly Father to bring torment, to burn this place up, man. And the city is going to be thrown down. And again, this is what John the Revelator seen. John the Revelator is prophesying what we're living today, man. We could see it, and now we are back prophesying the downfall of this place, and we could see the World War III is coming up over the horizon. It's inevitable. And the result of World War III is going to lead to the destruction of America, man.
The downfall of Esau.
That's right. You want to jump to verse 20?
Verse 20, it says, in Rizal, rejoice over her, thou heavens, and ye holy apostles and prophets, mm-hmm, for Yahweh Shemeshah had a vengeance on her, mm-hmm, and a mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone and cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down.
That's
and
right.
Shall be found no more at all.
See, the Lord said for the wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and his sins reach up to the heaven. This is why he has to bring plagues to America. And another reason is also because the Lord is avenging for us. Mm-hmm. You know, Esau, Edom has the apple of the Lord's eye in captivity. Mm-hmm. And they constantly, for years and years, decades, have dealt with us treacherously, unfairly. They further the affliction. So the Lord, as according to Deuteronomy 28 and 68, and no man shall buy you, meaning shall deliver you or redeem you or save you. Now the Lord is coming to save us. You know, he's avenging you on her. He's avenging Babylon. He's avenging Babylon for us.
Yeah, that's
you
right.
know.
That's right.
And he said the mighty angel took up a great millstone and cast into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down and shall be found no more at all. So this is going to be the end chapter, the end of America. And ultimately, it's synonymous with the end of Esau, Edom's rulership, man.
Yeah, because the Lord Yahweh Shemeshiah has a sense of humor, right?
Mm-hmm.
Poetic justice, and that's how Esau came into power, by violence, right? So the Lord gonna use the same weapon that this devil created to take them down. He also gonna use the Edomite Russian to take you down, to take you Edomite American down. You
that's
know what I'm
right.
saying? That's exactly what it is, man. What goes around comes around, you know?
Yeah, come real quick. I'm was gonna get Jeremiah, but just because you said that, I'm gonna get Isaiah. What's that? Isaiah 54, verse 16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. I have created the waster to destroy.
Yeah, the Lord created the smith, right? The smith are what you call modern day scientists, right? Mm-hmm. The Lord gave them the idea, the technology to pretty much come up with the weapons, the ICBMs, intercontinental ballistic missiles, you know? So they're going to use those missiles that they're going to use. They're going to destroy themselves, man. You
that's
know,
right.
That's exactly how it is. The Lord is a core power. And that's exactly why The scripture says that it's a Hebrews 10 and 21. It's a
fearful thing to fall in the hands of the living power.
That's exactly what it is, man. The Lord gonna reward these devils just like they reward us, man. You know.
Come on, and we read it for the Lord that judgeth her. This is all the will of the Heavenly Father. Mm-hmm. He's the one that's putting the spirit on all these other nations, pretty much to press the button. They're gonna press the button on these missiles and shoot at America.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
That's right. Because also, right, the spirit of Yahweh Shemeshah is going to be guiding those missiles.
Yeah, that's 2nd Ezra 16 and 13.
That's right.
Come on. I got a Jeremiah 50, verse 13. Because of the wrath of the Lord, it shall not be inhabited, but it shall be wholly desolate. Everyone that goeth by Babylon shall be astonished and hissed at all her plagues.
Yeah, because ultimately, when it does settle down, when it's all said and done, this place, America, will never be inhabited anymore. So, like, it will never be inhabited anymore. I mean, this place is going to stay as a symbol of wickedness for what happened to a nation that goes against everything that the Lord Yahweh Shemshai says not to do.
Yeah, it's going to be a huge bonfire for centuries.
Yeah, a memorial.
You know, a memorial.
That's right.
And it's going to show that, you know, this is what happens when you live unrighteously.
Unrighteously, yeah.
And wickedly against the Heavenly Father, you know. Verse 14, put yourselves in array against Babylon round about. All ye that bend the bow, shoot at her, spare no arrows, for she have sinned against the Lord.
Yeah, that's exactly how it is, right? Because Proverbs 21 verse 1 says, the king's heart is in the hand. So like, yeah, Proverbs 21 verse 1 says, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord Yahweh Shemeshai. And as the river of water, he turneth whithersoever it will. So the Lord is the one that controls the mind frame, the mindset of these devils, man. The Lord gonna give them, put his spirit on them to push those buttons to destroy this place, to take this place down.
That's right. You see, and again, these are the dark sayings or the parables when it says, you know, the bend a bow, spare no arrows, you know, in a military term of a missile. Or is considered an arrow.
Broken arrow.
A broken arrow. When they say, when they missing a nuclear missile, they say it's a broken arrow. See? So we can decipher the hidden sayings and through the prophecies and know what it's talking about.
That's
and
right.
It's talking about thermonuclear missiles, man.
That's right. Come on.
I'll read it again, verse 14. Put yourselves in array against Babylon round about. All ye that bend the bow, shoot at her, spare no arrows.
Yeah, because that's exactly what it is, right? Because the other day we did a lesson how North Korea, you know, and Iran, pretty much they're getting ready. They are investing in their military might.
That's right.
Right? That's them putting themselves in array against Babylon. They are getting ready for Babylon because this nation, they know that this place is going down, and they know that Esau is not gonna go down unwinkfully. He's gonna fight to keep his lies deception going. So that's exactly what they doing by investing in their military might.
That's right. They're trying to stock up on, you know, anti-defense missiles, supersonic missiles, all these other nations. And it's all like you said, it's the Lord putting that spirit of war and spirit of hate to get ready. And that's, again, the weak, as the scripture says, let the weak say I'm strong.
That's right.
You know, now all these other nations have that thermonuclear missile capability, and they're tired of Babylon, aka America, being the hammer of the whole earth, that big bad bully. So when Esau, Edom, well, representing America, tries to come down and put military garrison bases, or put sanctions on other nations, the Lord's gonna put the spirit on these guys to actually send a message. And we, like we said, I think we did the lesson yesterday about North Korea.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you have these other nations just shooting out their missiles, like just target practicing, that just shows they're getting prepared for the game. They're getting prepared for the war, battle. Huh?
They're rehearsing.
They're rehearsing.
That's right.
Just like the elect are rehearsing the righteous act, the Lord got these other nations rehearsing the wars,
the war games.
Jeremiah 50 verse 16, cut off the sower from Babylon and him that handleth the sickle in the time of harvest, for fear of the oppressing sword, they shall turn everyone to his people, and they shall flee everyone to his own land.
Yeah, because that's our message, right? There's no making America great again, man. This place is finished. You know, the great famine is gonna sweep through America, man.
That's
exactly what it is, man. And the Lord, before he take down this kingdom, the Lord gonna surgically pretty much destroy every infrastructure that this devil set up in place, man.
Yeah,
you know?
Khan, I skipped verse 15, so lock it. Shoot against her round, shout against her round about. She have given her hand, her foundations are fallen, her walls are thrown down, for it is the vengeance of the Lord. Take vengeance upon her as she has done do unto her.
As she had done do unto her. And that's again, like I said before, that's poetic justice, man.
Yes,
as
sir.
She had done do unto her, you know, just like they did us dirty as a nation. Guess
yep.
what? We have an avenger. Yahweh Shai is an avenger, you know what I'm saying? And he's gonna come to pretty much give us a vengeance, to give us a retribution against these devils, man.
That's
you know,
right.
These devils, they are not gonna go unpunished. They're gonna be judged for all the wicked deed that they have to done to others. To
That's
others,
right.
You know?
And it says the vengeance of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
So this is why we can confidently and go out and prophesy the downfall of America, because we know the words of the Lord goes without void, and this is going to happen. It's impossible for the Most High to lie, you know. And the Scripture says, "The vision is yet for an appointed time. Even though it tarry, wait for it; it shall not tarry." So we're just waiting for that day, and the Lord's leaving these signs, these clues, these crumbs that hey, we at that time in the brinks of war, World War III,
right.
And we know it's a cold war right now. That you know it's like through communication or through
propaganda,
and yeah, but soon when it becomes a physical and they start shooting the missiles, hey, it's over for America. America is prophesied to be defeated, you
That's
know.
Right.
Continuing on that same chapter, I'm gonna jump down. Jeremiah 50 verse 23. Unless you got something.
No.
Jeremiah 50 verse 23. How is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? How is Babylon become a desolation among the nations? I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon, and thou was not aware. Thou art found and also caught, because thou hast striven against the Lord. The Lord have opened his armory and have brought forth the weapons of his indignation, for this is the work of the Lord Yahweh of hosts in the land of the Chaldeans. If I may ask, see, the Lord have opened up his armory, meaning he's pretty much gripping up. We said that the Lord's spirit is in these missiles and in these other nations, you know, so he's pretty much have these modern day science constantly making these thermonuclear missiles. He put that spirit back into Russia to have that USSR spirit, to be a guard unto these other nations, to have nuclear deals and anti-defense mechanisms. You know, he, as the scripture says, turn away your spears. No, yeah. The pruner hooks.
Into spears. Like the weak Sam Sean.
Yeah, yeah, Khan. So the Lord is putting that spirit of war and ultimately that armory that's going to be opened up against Babylon is all these thermonuclear missiles. It's been prophesied in Revelation, the 9th chapter.
That's the spirit.
Yeah, Khan. The 200 million missiles is going to hit Babylon the Great.
Yeah.
So that's how this place is going to be utterly destroyed, and no, it's going to be a confused line of confusion. Yeah.
And if I may add, right, that the missiles are the army of the Lord, man.
That's right.
That's exactly what the Lord going to use to take down this place, man. Revelation chapter 9 verse 16, and the number of the army or the horsemen were 200,000, and I heard the number of them.
The number of the horsemen is them, not the chariot, Shalaka, it's them thermonuclear missiles. You know, 200,000 equals 200 million missiles. So this is why this place is going to, this is why the world is ultimately going to reel to and fro like a drunkard, because that's deep impact. That's many missiles hitting this place, man.
Yeah, that's right. You're going to have all kind of tsunamis,
yeah.
Earthquakes, you know, the island's going to be removed from the places, you know. Pretty much the landmass gonna change, man. You know what I'm saying? That's exactly what it is, man. You're gonna have new landmass, new, you know, because when the missiles pretty much like I said before, when the missiles pretty much rain it down on America, the earth gonna rain pretty much shake to and fro, man.
That's right.
You know, that's a devastating time, man.
That's
and
right.
That's exactly why the Lord gonna have to remove the elect from of the planet, you know.
Yeah, and the reason why the Lord is bringing this thermonuclear missiles as fire is because we already read that this place is polluted, this place is filthy. So a fire is like a purging cleaning agent. You got to get rid of all the filth, man.
Yeah, yeah.
You have to. And there's so much filth throughout the whole four corners of the earth. This is why even other nations are going to get hit with thermonuclear missiles. But it's been prophesied that America is going to be utterly destroyed because, like the brother mentioned, this is the epic center of wickedness. This is Satan's seat, pretty much. And this place got to be removed before the kingdom of heaven and the Lord rules, man.
Yeah, if I may add, right? When you have cancer in your body, right? They got to do something, use fire, laser to take it out.
That's
and
right.
It's all the cancer that the Lord going to use the missiles to get rid of, man.
That's right.
That's exactly what it is, man.
And that's what John the Revelator seen, the lake of fire. It's not hell. This is not a place where you die and your soul goes to, or they say hell, and it burns for eternal, and you're with a red beast with a pitchfork and horns. No, that lake of fire is what it's talking about, what John the Revelator seen America going through. And it's going to be a lake of fire because there's also the elect are gonna have that vision in the chariots to see that fire burning, man.
Yeah, it's gonna be like a nuclear holocaust, man.
That's right. That's right.
The whole land gonna be on fire, you know.
Con, I got just one more. I don't know if you got more.
I got something real quick.
Yeah,
Revelation 16, verse 18. Motherfucker, Revelation chapter 16, Revelation 17 and 16, right? And he reads, in the ten horns which thou sawest upon the beast, they shall hit the whore and shall make her desolate naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. You know, the ten horns talking about the NATO and the EU.
That's
even
right.
their own Edomite counterpart, they're gonna come against America, man. They're gonna destroy it.
As the scripture says, Satan cast out Satan. How can he survive? Because he's divided, roughly paraphrasing. But it says also the whore.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes back to, again, America, the analogy of her being a woman. And that whore is someone who is like an adulteress, a wicked woman, you know, that needs to be put to death.
Yeah, that's in the law.
That's the law, An adulterous woman, you know.
Come. Over 17, for Yahweh Shemeshai had put in the hearts to fulfill his will and to agree and to give the kingdom unto the beast, until the word of the Messiah shall be fulfilled.
That's right. And see, this is the will of the Heavenly Father. And this is why majority of all the prophets in the Bible seen the vision of seeing this destruction, whether it's Ezra's, whether it's Isaiah, whether it's Jeremiah, whether it's Malachi, whether Habakkuk, whether Nahum. So on and so forth, man. The destruction of this place, John the Revelator, you know. This place is going to be utterly destroyed. The Lord put the visions on all these prophets. And now, if thou can get it, the prophets are here today speaking about it now.
That's right.
And we can see the downfall of this place. We can see that World War III is inevitable. And World War III, America is not going to win. They always push in their movies or their video games or whatever that they always come up on top and always victorious. But you can't fight the hands of the Lord. You know, your arms is too short to box with God. You know, and it's already been declared. The movie, we already have the ending.
Mm-hmm.
We already know that America's gonna be destroyed. So now we're just playing it out. Kind of like a Martin Scorsese film. Sometimes they or a Quentin Tarantino film. Mm-hmm. The beginning of the movie shows what happened in the end, and then it'll rewind and show you how they got to the end through the beginning.
That's
you know what I'm saying? So we already know the end. Again, as the scripture said, the Lord declared the end
from the beginning.
So this is here just to give you warning that hey, we already know what time it is. We already know what's going to happen to America. We almost out of here, man.
Mm-hmm.
And so, thus, when 1 hour shall that great city Babylon be thrown down, man.
Mm-hmm.
Thus, with violence.
Come.
You know, you got anything else, bro?
One more. This is Proverbs 22:3. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hide it from self, right? You know, a prudent man, a wise man, the prophets, right?
Mm-hmm.
Foreseeth. Because before time, the prophets were known as seers, man. So, we have the foresight. We
yes,
have
sir.
The vision. We see what's to take place. We know the future, right?
Yep.
A prudent man foresee the evil and hide it from self. So, how do you hide yourself? You hide yourself underneath the shadow of Yahweh Hashem Shai by taking heed, you know? By taking heed to the doctrine, you know?
Yeah, and prophesying.
Come.
You know, because that's our job. Real quick, Jeremiah 28, verse 8. The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms of war and of evil and of pestilence.
Mm.
And that's why we said the prophets are here again, you know, and we're here. Our job is to prophesy the downfall against many countries. And we're the main country and great kingdom that's been prophesying against is Babylon the Great.
Mm-hmm.
And the nation that's not going to rule anymore is Esau, Edom.
That's right.
You know, and of war, hey, World War III is the reason why Esau, Edom is going to be removed and Babylon is going to be destroyed. Of evil, because it's going to be bad time for the wicked. It's going to be good time for the elect. And we pray we're part of that hopeful elect. And of pestilence. And we know it's all type of diseases, famines, plagues that the Lord said, as we read, he's going to bring on the earth. And this is what's coming, man.
Come on. It says, our uprooted men foresee the evil and hide it from Saul. But the simple pass on and are punished.
That's right.
And that's like what it is. Of people, the vast majority of you so-called Black Hispanics and Native Americans, you're going to get caught out there, man. You're not going to know what to do when all her recluse, man. Why? Because you didn't take heed, man.
Yeah,
because
you're non-belief.
You know? Yeah. This is wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of that time, right? So we're going to be stable because we know what's taking place, right? We know the future. So we try to be in good graces of Yahweh Hashem Shai by taking heed, by doing what's required of us. But our people, they out there, they not pay attention. So when all hell be close, they gonna be cut off guard, man.
And even that's prophesied. 2/3 of our people must be cut off and die, but they're gonna be left there in to go through the fire and ultimately be delivered when them chariots come, man. You got anything else, bro?
No, I'm good.
So with that, man, we pray everything was edifying. Again, Babylon the Great, aka America, is gonna be utterly destroyed. Ain't gonna be no upset or no disrupting or pausing the prophecies of the Heavenly Father, you know. And we're just here to pretty much give out that warning, you know, and to seal the hopeful elect so we can get out of here, man. So with that, we want to give all praises, honor, and glory to
Yahweh
Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem Rakakadash. Double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone, who rule well and taught us this truth and peace, and salutation to the Bayav Dawada, that's the house of David, the elect. Until next time, we want to say Adonwan Ratazah, which means Lord willing, Shalom.